is my living.
Slow down. You have to remember that you're the one that put yourself in this situation, and each of our sessions, you seem to keep forgetting that. Now, I know that Wayne may be a burden on you sometimes, but you have to remember that you're the one that stood at the altar.
Hold up now. Lynn, first of all, I thought that when I come to you, I thought that maybe you would be human with me whenever I'm here. I mean, if I wanted to be preached to, I'll just wait till Sunday morning, which isn't too far from now.
Listen, I know you probably think I'm being really deep, but there's a big difference between being deep and being honest.
There you go again. Where'd you hear that one?
Listen, maybe you should stop by next week, because right now it seems like you have a lot going on, and I have the right to admit as well as dismiss.
Look, I'm sorry, Lynn. I'm just having a rough day. Fine. You know what's his name is already out there waiting. I'll just tell him to come on in.
Oh, please do.
Have Bye. A good day.
Oh, hey Sammy, how are you?
I'm doing better. Just trying to cope with people staring at me at school.
Okay, how does that make you feel?
Great.
Okay, well, I can sure tell you one thing, Sammy.
You know the dude Keith? He's real tough, like a mean guy.
What does he do?
I don't know. He's just annoying, I guess. Always has a small remark to say about me. Sort of like in the movies. You know, they always gotta have some sort of inspiration for all that bullying stuff. It's from reality. Probably my life.
Sammy, now you know that one of my rules is that you don't downplay your issues. What you're experiencing is not normal behavior. It's actual abnormal, and watching those movies could make you think that it is normal. But it's not. You know what? I want you to do something for me, Sammy.
Okay.
I want you to fight.
And lose?
No, I don't mean really. I mean, I want you to stand up for yourself. And when you do it, I want you to call me.
But you want me to give you
Yes, I'm going to give you my number.
Is that even allowed?
Have a good day, Sammy. Tell your parents I said hello.
Okay, Miss Lynn. I guess I can do it for you.
No, do it for you, Sammy.
Things at the firm are going well. There's something I want to talk to you about.
Okay, go ahead.
So I was reading my Bible. Come on, Lynn, don't do that. That's the point of these sessions, right? You better read. So you should be surprised that your work actually works.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to offend you, but trust me, I know that my work works.
All right, well, I was reading my Bible, and it says that God is a patient God. But if he's such a patient God, how come you won't allow me to grow without negative circumstances?
Okay, what do you mean by grow?
Yes, you don't. See, I don't go to church 24/7 like I used to. And ever since I stopped going, all these crazy things have been happening in my life.
Well, Wayne, sometimes when you pull away from the source, you can begin to get drained. And if you aren't going to church on a regular basis or putting forth any effort.
Whoa. I'll put forth effort. I'm reading my Bible. I don't need you to be judging me.
I'm not judging you. I'm just listening and responding based on what I hear.
Well, maybe you can't hear correctly.
Wayne, listen, this is the stuff that we've been working on. I don't want you going backwards. I know it's hard, but at some point, you're going to have to accept it.
I accept it. I just don't agree.
Okay, that's fine.
Looks like someone is running up in time. We need to get out of here.
All right, girl. It was nice talking to you, Lynn.
You too, Wayne. Have a good day.
Going through, maybe you need to go somewhere where they can actually prescribe you medicine, because what you're doing in here is interfering with my conscience.
Girl.
Well, yeah. Hello there.
Hello.
Long day?
No, not at all.
Okay. Well, last week we started
talking about my will for power.
You know what? I'm going to pull up your notes because we go through a lot of different topics in our sessions and I can't really pinpoint where we need to start.
Oh no, I think we should start right
here. Wait, Gabrielle. I think I got it.
Okay, well, you tell me where you want to start, and then I'll let you
Gabrielle, I got it. So, last week we talked about ways that you can tone down on always desiring to be in control.
And knowing when to speak.
And we're still working on that part. We really have to get you out of that habit.
What habit? Okay, fine, whatever.
Listen, Gabrielle, you know, sometimes we mask our weaknesses by trying to be so strong and so vibrant and by having so much fun, but at some point, like any mask, it's gonna have to come off. Each week you come here and you pretend that nothing is going on, you're so strong, but I can't really get down to the bottom of what you're dealing with if you don't really show me who you really are. I try my hardest to give you good advice and back it up with scripture, but you're putting on mask after mask after mask.
You know, I'm sorry. This is too much.
Well, it's okay to smile every now and then.
So I guess you'd be smiling. This restaurant was just leaving there.
I'm sorry.
No need to be. Don't need to be sorry. It just feels good to sometimes say exactly what's on my mind.
Well, that's great. I want you to say what's on your mind.
Well. 6 months. You want to take notes?
Well, I just thought I would listen for a while.
Take notes. 6 months later, and people are still stupid enough to ask me how my son is doing. It just happened today at the grocery store. Like, don't they know? I know they watch the news.
Well, I'm sure that they know what's going
on. It's disrespectful. My son was beaten today. Every tooth in his mouth was knocked out. His eyeball, it just hang on his cheek and his knee. You want me to tell you about his knee?
No, that's okay.
Exactly. But you want me to smile every now and then, but you can't even smile while listening to two small descriptions about my kid. Why you stop taking notes? Let me take them. Maybe you can spare them.
Isabel, listen. I can't even imagine you're hurt. And I wouldn't even sit here and pretend like I can, but we've come so far.
I don't want
to go backwards.
Yeah. I thought I just told you why. Maybe now, I guess you'll start taking notes.
Someone had to ask him about his son.
Israel, Vengeance, 47.
Gabrielle, 24. I should have been the first to speak. Power, greed.
Then gave me a scripture that says, the righteous cry out and the Lord hears them, and he delivers them from out of all of their troubles. Psalms 34:17.
The Lord Almighty has a day in store for the proud and lofty. For those who are exalted shall be humble. Isaiah 2:12.
You should not commit adultery. Exodus 20:14.
It is mine to avenge. I will repay. For in due time their foot will slip, the day of disaster is near, and their doom rushes upon them. Deuteronomy 32:35.
And then he said unto them, watch out, be on your guard against all types of greed. A man's life does not consist in the abundance of his possessions. Luke 12:15.
I have told you these things, so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world. John 16:33.
I'm sure you heard a bit of my story in my session with Lenny. You see, I had a son. He was 18 years old, a senior in high school. Growing up, I was a bad guy. I was the one in gangs, beating up classmates, male or female. I guess it's kind of hard for you to feel sorry for me now. But see, I grew up on the path of weed, coke, cigarettes, alcohol, but I didn't want that for my son. Hypocritical? Yeah. After I graduated high school, and I guess it's good that I actually did graduate, I got myself together. See, my son, he didn't know about my past life. The man he knew me to be was a hard-working Christian man, and that's all I ever wanted. But what I knew of my son was who I used to be. And that lifestyle is what killed him. Why me, though? Would it be wrong for me to avenge my son's death? I'm asking y'all, would it be wrong for me to avenge my son's death?
So Lord, what do I do? just need a word from you. Tell me which way to turn. I need a word. Tell me which way I should go.
What's good, tough guy? Isn't today Eat Lunch With Your Father Day?
Yeah, so what?
Are you sad or no?
Why would I be sad? Hey, could you get out of my face?
Man, you're so scary. I bet your mama gotta go downstairs just to see what the noise is her own self.
You know you're lame, right?
What's really lame is you eat lunch all by yourself while everybody else is in your father. You know what? I don't recall seeing your dad come in the cafeteria.
Hey, son, Sammy. Come on, I'm already late.
Well, that makes two of us. Because I don't remember seeing your father in the cafeteria either. Maybe that's why you're so bitter. I'm coming, Dad.
Hello? Listen, I scratched it off yesterday and they told me I won when I called up there. I can't come up there right now. You know, I'm at this school about to embarrass my brother because I have to eat lunch with him and not our deadbeat dad. So you listen to me and you listen carefully. I need my money.
Today wasn't a very good day.
Oh yeah? Why not?
It's been 3 months. I mean, 3 weeks since I lost that case.
Wayne, you can't win everything.
You think that's something I want to hear right now? My name means a lot to me in this state.
I know.
Alright. So tell me. It's one thing for me to lose a case. It's another thing for me to lose my wife.
Okay, come on, son. Let's go to your room.
No, let him stay. I think he needs to hear how his mother has been handling herself in these streets.
Oh, I'll take him to his room.
Alyssa, granted, we don't have the perfect love story. No, we didn't. No, we weren't high school sweethearts. And no, we didn't fall in love at a young age. But if it was one thing I thought I could depend on, it was you.
Wait,
let me speak. I went to law school. I met you there. And you practically cheated my whole way through. I guess I should be your secretary instead of you being mine. But let's be real. The only reason I got the firm in the first place is because I'm the man. You deserve a house, a home, built from the ground up. Yeah, this is a nice complex. Really nice, actually. But you're the greatest woman on the face of the earth, and you deserve better. You pick our son up, you take him to school, you cook, clean, shop, plan for the firm, iron both of our clothes. You do so much. You deserve better. I know you saw me.
Don't.
At the hotel. See, my first instincts was to get you back. So I met with my assistant, and we went to the hotel, and we sat on the bed.
Yeah, I saw you, and I really don't have time to hear this.
I looked at her, and at that very moment, I was confused because how was I getting ready to cheat on you with a woman, and her sheer presence alone disgusted me. But you, went once courting with, sleeping with, another man that wasn't your husband. And you did it so peacefully.
It was a mistake.
And that's what we agreed. It was a mistake. I looked at my assistant, I offered to call her a taxi. Of course, she was confused because she was ready, but I called a taxi. Of course, Lynn drove in my head that two wrongs don't make a right. But I stormed out of her office that day, and I met up with my sister at that hotel. Nothing didn't happen, though. After that, I watched you. How living a double life didn't seem to even affect you. You still kiss me daily. We made love. I'm sorry, had sex. And you even argued with me. And you still managed to be yourself.
I will break it off.
And Wayne, who is this Wayne? You went from calling me baby, babe, and occasionally babe, to call me by my first name only. I just want you to know I'm finished. I'm through. I'm done.
Wayne, I promise you this time, I cannot live without you.
Try.
Something
I'm taking our son.
No!
Hey girl, I didn't think you were gonna come home.
Of course.
Okay, so boom, let me tell you.
Gabrielle, we gotta talk, girl.
Okay.
It's like every time we hang out now, all you talk about is making money or trying to get ahead on your job. And I do not want to hear that all the time.
Girl, I feel like you're tripping.
No, I stopped by your house the other day and you weren't there. I ran into Lynn.
Right. I knew it because you don't ever talk to me like this. So what did you tell her?
Girl, and you know what's so funny about this? I wish you all the time. It should be me who should be giving her all of the insight.
Well, did you give it to her?
I asked her how you were doing and she said you were doing well and she couldn't tell me anything else. Why are you drinking?
Mind your business, but this drink right here is not gonna be the drink that get me sent to hell.
You know I love you, right?
Yeah.
And I want what's best for you.
Yeah.
I just feel like as friends we should be helping each other out. And I just feel like you're more of a burden to me than anything else. It's like you're my kid, man. You get sloppy drunk, I gotta clean you up, bathe you, tuck you in at night, and let's not mention all the time I have to pay your bills because you lost your money gambling and all this extra stuff.
But true friends stick around through everything.
Well, if you don't consider me a true friend for giving you all those chances, but for taking a step back, well, maybe you did consider me as your mom.
You know what? I'm so tired of this. I'm so tired of you and everybody else out here judging me. No one knows what it's like to grow without a mom. No one knows what it's like to grow without a dad. No one knows what it's like to grow up alone. So excuse me if I must do what makes me happy. Because nothing in this life ever has.
Yeah, yeah, I believe you. Don't say when.
A lot to take in, right? But isn't this normal? Well, let's not call it normal, but aren't these guys facing struggles that are relative to what some of you could be facing? I'm sure none of you in here have ever been drunk, cheers, arrogant, vengeful, or depressed, but you could be. It's human nature to struggle. It's human nature to want to do the wrong thing. It's human nature to want to get someone back when they've wronged you. It's even human nature to want to leave your spouse because they cheated on you. It's human nature to become overwhelmed with being bullied and picked on every day that you feel led to take your own life. But we can't be so caught up in our nature that we forget what we really are.
As God's people, we're strong, we're resilient, we're smart, and we do have the ability to overcome. They will overcome.
Lynn, I gotta talk to you now.
Okay, come on, sit down.
Never thought you'd be here before me. Last time we talked, you said you'd be a better man. It just sucks, because you never really got that chance. You're probably clowning me right now. For sounding such like a joker, man.
Hey, what's going on, man?
Oh, what's up, man? Just talking to you, son.
Yeah, I usually come out here and see him, too. I don't usually see you on weekends.
Nah, weekends, remember? But ever since you cut things off with Alyssa, you're the one that's been coming on off days.
I guess you're right.
Come
but
on,
yeah, man, I'm done with that.
I got you, brother. Let's walk. I saw them cats the other day, boy. I had to grab a waist for about 5 seconds.
Man,
you know the therapist I see? She like to tell me that vengeance is the Lord's.
She right.
Look at you, Mr. Stealing Your Woman.
Nah, come on, man. This just ain't right. You don't want to spend the rest of your life in jail. I don't even want that for you.
Hey, man, I might have to.
Okay, class, go ahead and complete your work.
Hey, yo, Sammy, what's the answer to number 5, 6, 13, and 25? I know we just started the test, but I bet you probably already finished. Hey, yo, Sammy, I said, what's the answer to the test? You're about to make me get up. I said, what's the answer to the test?
We're having.
What else were you supposed to do?
I don't know. How many times do you want to
remember? You told me to fight.
Yeah, but remember, I wasn't talking about physically.
Well, that's what happened. This guy and his friends, they make my life miserable. And it doesn't even stop at school. It continues on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. I'm always the quiet guy, but I got fed up this time.
That's what I'm talking about. You gotta put those people in their places or they gonna keep coming back for more.
So we fought. He said I gave him a black guy and I haven't seen him at school since.
Wait. What? Your name is Sammy? Sit back. You're that Sammy kid?
Yeah.
How could you do that? My brother looks up to you.
Oh, she is so gal.
Talking about his friend and how you were just such a great friend to him. Like,
What?
He came home that one day you were talking about, saying that you turned your back against him and became a bully?
I was never friends with your brother. Your brother has always been a pain in my neck. I don't know why he would come home and tell you all those lies. If we were such friends, how come you didn't even recognize me? If we were friends, how come I never came over to your house? We were never friends, little girl. So the next time you try to talk to me about friends, don't.
Oh my goodness! Yes.
Sometimes you
Gabrielle had a fit. And Israel took to his gun. No one was hurt, thank God. I knew what I was getting myself into when I decided to have a group session, but to me, the good outweighed the bad. Did I know that Sammy and Gabrielle would bump heads? Did I know Israel and Wayne would get into it? Did I know that the session would be chaotic? I did. And see, here's where the healing begins. I know you all are probably thinking, what kind of woman are you to cheat on your husband and to ruin a happy family? Well, the truth is, this family wasn't happy. You see, Wayne and I, we both struggled with certain things. He was controlling, yet distant. Sweet, yet sour. But most importantly, he was always busy. And as a woman and a wife, also working, fending for our child, making sure everything was taken care of, I was just missing some affection. It started off with a little text message, 2-minute phone calls here and there. But how many of you guys know if you give the enemy a centimeter, oh, he'll take the yard.
We could have easily met with Lynn for marriage counseling. In other words, there is always a solution. But you see, I've been praying and I've been fasting and I really want my marriage back. I mean, sometimes things just get so rough that I don't know where to start.
I had it bad. I remember when Lynn made me break down and cry because she saw who I really was, even though I wouldn't show her. It's true. I have a habit with money. If you all were to go in my room right now, it would be full of lottery tickets. Not only gambling and lottery, though. I would pawn any and everything that I can find that has some worth. Pawning my laptop, TV, purses, wallets, and my brother's video game.
I became obsessed with wanting power. Now, some of you all may say that's the small things. I can overcome gambling and desire and control. I got so caught up in the silly things that I overlooked my brother's hurt. There he was right there in front of me, and I missed it all. Now, I was reading my word last night, and the scripture that popped in my head was Mark 8:36. Which reads, what good is it for a man to gain the entire world, yet forfeit his soul? So, I'm gonna try to do better. I'm gonna try.
I'm a bit embarrassed. I allowed my heartache to control my right mind. If it wasn't for Lynn lying to me, I'd probably be in jail right now. Yeah, I pulled a gun on Wayne. But truthfully, he had every right to be mad. I'm not a crazy dude, though. I went to church on Sunday, and something really weird happened. The pastor prophesied to me. He told me that God said, if I don't let this thing go and just put it in his hands, I'm gonna be living a life full of misery. And it's true, because I'm already living.
You see, my son had a chance to get his life together. And this is for all you parents out here right now. You can take your child to church on Sunday, every Sunday on time. You can beat the commandments into them, into their minds and their hearts. But if they screw up, it's not on you. I'm learning to not let my son's decision influence mine. I'm also learning to not let them affect me. You see, I'm growing, and I'm learning.
Jordan, you probably feel bad for me. That's not what I want. What I want you to feel and see is the real me. Not the vulnerable and careful me. The real me. The guy who sit in the classroom and allow kids to talk about me and ridicule me without saying a word. The guy who did everyone's homework, who slid their tests to the side of the desk so my classmates could cheat off my work. The pushover. Because from what you guys have seen of me, it has only allowed you to feel one emotion, and that's sadness. But what I want you to feel is confusion. Because why would I possibly allow people to talk about me and sit back and do nothing? Why would I come home each night being angry with God and questioning if he's even real? Why would I, a young Christian man, not pray my troubles away? Well, it's okay if you don't feel that way. Because I do. Looking back over everything, I'm so, so disappointed in myself. I give up on God. And yes, the bullies were wrong. But I knew better than to make a permanent decision based off temporary circumstances. But now, I can stand here proudly and say, I'm alive. I'll go to God with my problems now. I'll stand up for myself. I won't be silent. God is there all the time, and he witnesses my every problem. And he is always orchestrating a way to work it out. This is not okay.
I'm sure all of you hate me and think I deserve everything that I'm getting. I get it. I'm a loudmouth, proud, fearless person. But the truth is, I'm none of those things. Well, maybe one, two of them. But I'm honestly trying. One of my friends told me that sometimes God allows things to happen to us so that they'll humble us. How ironic, right? I do believe that's true.
Slowly but surely, I'm becoming who God has always intended me to be. I read my Bible more, and not because it's the politically correct thing for Christians to do, but because I want to. You guys really want to know what's hard for me to do right now, though? Is move back in with my wife. And trust me, I've asked God to help me forgive her. I can't do it yet.
I decided to stop, reclaim regrets, and I decided to tell my past goodbye.
You won't steal my future. Yeah.
hear how y'all are doing.
Wayne?
Things are going quite well. I decided to work on myself more and be real with God, because, I mean, he sees everything anyway.
Yeah, that's true.
I decided to better myself and try not to be so...
arrogant? No, I'm just kidding.
Yes, arrogant. Prideful. But there's whole books on these things. You'll be surprised. I've been trying to work on myself and work things out with my wife, though.
And I'm learning how to be more genuine and being real to myself. And I haven't played the lottery in weeks.
Hey!
Now I know God is most definitely pleased.
I'm finally finding myself. I'm not so down in the dumps anymore. I'm going to church and actually listening during services. And Keith and I, we made amends.
Well, I've just been taking it one day at a time. And you know, I know y'all watch the news, right? Yeah, they caught them jokers, boy. Yeah! Oh, man. I'm at peace now. But I still, you know, I let my son go, I let him go, and I'm just learning to just, not that his decision is going to affect me anymore. I'm just moving on and keeping God first.
Well, as you know, I double up on my counseling sessions with Glenn. I've also learned to forgive myself for my wrongdoings, as well as my husband for his. I stopped by the Christian bookstore and picked up some books on how to become a good wife, and also on how to overcome lust and infidelity.
That's awesome. I'm so great that you all are doing so well. Well, here's what I've been doing. I've been taking care of me. You know, after dealing with all of y'all, I really needed some time to myself. You know, as a therapist, I tend to get so wrapped up into what you're going through that I forget about me. And this is exactly what I wanted you all to see all along, that you do have the power to overcome. God sends the battle to his strongest warriors. And I knew all along that each of you would make it through. Well, I guess that's all for today.
Hey.
It's so great to see you.
Bow down.
They seem to be the meat of this entire story. What happened to them, you may ask? Let's take a look. Yes, I'm happy for you all as well. I'll definitely let them know that you're appreciative of the firm and all of our hard work.
Alyssa?
Yes, I'll talk to you later. Goodbye.
I just want to thank you for all that you've done in helping us win this case.
Oh, baby.
No, seriously. We couldn't do it without you. And I've been doing some thinking lately. I just want to apologize to you.
You shouldn't be apologizing.
Well, I'm going to. Alyssa Brockington, I absolutely love you.
The sun.